What's going on, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. In this video, we're talking about how I transformed my completely empty property into a 14-unit, fully functioning RV park. So this is my property here, right when I had first bought it back in November of 2019, and it was completely raw. It had no utilities, no road, nothing. Just pretty much completely covered in trees, except for a few bald spots here and there. And the way to get to my property was very beautiful. It had a beautiful view as you were going up a hill, and it's in a very desirable area. And the first thing that I decided to do was to carve a road. And so my property is like a rectangle. And so I figured, okay, the best way that I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna have the entrance and exit relatively close to each other. And I'm going to try to save as much material as possible. So I made the road pretty short and I just began cutting down some stumps. And that's really the easiest way to get started when you're trying to change your property from an empty property to an RV park, is map out the road and then start cutting stuff down. You can just get a chainsaw and maybe find somebody with a stump grinder, and you can easily take the stumps out and start to carve your road. All right, so the next part of infrastructure that I began doing was the septic. Now in Texas, the first thing you do if you're planning to do a septic is to reach out to a civil engineer, somebody that's licensed in the state of Texas, and they draw up a map for you. So what I did, I reached out to an engineer that was licensed in Texas, and I told them exactly what I wanted. He then drew up a plan for me. I took that plan, submitted it to the county. I got the A-OK from the county that it was okay to begin installing a septic. I began to then get bids for septic installers. Eventually I found somebody that was within the budget that I wanted, and he began installing the septic at my property. So he began trenching the lines to each individual lot, putting the piping down, and also installing the actual septic system, which is what you're seeing here in this video. This is the actual septic system. This is an aerobic system, so it sprays back into the soil. But the septic is one of the biggest parts of infrastructure, and it's a essential part when starting an RV park. So prepare budget-wise for it to be one of the biggest parts of infrastructure. All right, so the next major part of infrastructure is gonna be the electricity. Now, I didn't realize, but you can actually put the electric and the septic in the same line. However, the water needs to be trenched in a different area. And so for the electric, I actually went with an electrical co-op that was local, and they put in some electric poles for me. Before I had them put in the electric poles, I actually hired an electrician to make a plan for me, which I gave to the co-op, and they knew where to put the poles and everything. And actually for the private side, I did all that myself. I just laid down the wire that I bought wholesale, and then I actually just chose which spots were going to be 50 amp, which spots were going to be 30 amp. That way I could save a little bit of money on materials. All right, for the next part of infrastructure, water, I actually have an unconventional way how I do things. I have a 6,000 gallon water tank, and I pretty much just propped it up and I started bringing in water from the local municipal water, which is provided by the county. Now that water is already regulated, and I just make a couple runs using a tote on the back of my truck that I fill up, and I just bring it out to my property. I have a little pump that pumps the water from the tote inside of the tank, and to get the lines drilled, I just rented a trencher and trenched lines to each individual lot. And it works pretty well, really. I haven't really had much problems with it. And I actually ended up building a little patio on top of this water tank. And I actually even painted it black, just so that it's not as much of an eyesore. It's more of actually an attraction now. So it has a little deck on top. And then I just have a little well house where I have a pressurizer and a little motor. And it just pretty much regulates the water pressure throughout the property. But it works pretty well, and it saved me probably about $20,000. It does take a little bit more labor, but it can definitely save you a lot of money. This is just kind of how I got my water started. All right, and the last part of infrastructure is roads. Now, roads have to be the last thing that you do, because obviously we're trenching all these lines. And so when we're done, we cover everything up, and then we, you know, either pave our road or we do what I did, which was crush granite, but you finish your road. That's the last thing you do. So for my road, I used a combination of caliche, which is naturally found on my property, combined with crushed granite. Now, the caliche was taken when I had installed the septic. I had a plentiful amount of caliche, which I used as a road base. And then I pretty much just ordered from a local company, local landscape company, I had ordered a large amount of crushed granite, and I just filled in the cracks, and it was pretty easy to do. It's definitely the cheapest way, and it doesn't look nearly as nice as if you use asphalt or concrete, but I'm telling you, it's gonna come at maybe like a tenth of the price. And I actually use crushed granite for my lots as well as for the road. One problem I do face sometimes is that when there's a lot of rain, we get washouts, but I'm not in an area that gets a ton of rain, so it's not a huge deal. I am planning actually to create borders around the roads. That way I can limit washout from happening. But crushed granite is a good way to get things done very cheaply. The county, when it comes to the roads, the only thing that they are paying attention to are the easements. So they want to know that in the case of an emergency, they can get a big vehicle in there, like a fire truck or whatever it is. And so the easements essentially are the entrances and the exits. They want to make sure that this truck can come on your property, that it can get through the roads, that your roads can handle big vehicles. Obviously, we're dealing with RVs, which weigh a lot. So your road needs to be able to support big vehicles. But I use crushed granite, which is definitely a cheap option. But that's how I got my roads done. And that kind of, in retrospect, guys, is how I transformed my 10-acre empty property into a property that now has 14 renters and it's making about $7,700 a month in monthly revenue. Now, it's not the prettiest RV park, obviously, and I'm still working on amenities. I'm still working on fine-tuning things, making it nicer and nicer every day. It needs a lot of work still. But nonetheless, this is a DIY. I'm just an average guy here on the internet talking to you about how I turn this property into a cash-flowing machine, making, you know, $7,000 a month. That's pretty good income when you think about it. So hopefully this video was able to give you some value. I'm really appreciative for the positive comments I get, the positive feedback. I hope these videos are providing value for you. I appreciate you guys watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Also, down below, I'm going to leave my email if you want to reach out to me via email. I'm exploring partnerships. I have a lot of stuff going on throughout the state of Texas right now when it comes to investments, but all over the place. So make sure to email me if you have something that you want to talk about. I'll get back to you. But I appreciate you guys watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Take care.